Welcome! Today I'm gonna throw some bigger pots that I will pit fire. So first of all, you have to figure out what clay you want to use. You have to figure out what strategy you want to use for throwing bigger pots. And finally, of course, you have to be careful that you don't throw them too big for your pit. So let's get on with it. You can probably see I put up the camera in a different way than what I usually do, so I have to crawl down here to talk to you. I hope it works better so you can see more of what I'm actually doing. The only downside is they won't be able to see my beautiful face when I do the throwing. You'll probably survive that. Anyway, first thing, of course you need to figure out what clay to use. As I mentioned in my other videos, you can use just about any clay for pit fire, but when I'm throwing bigger stuff, I do like to do it in stoneware with a bit of grog. One of my favorite clays is from George & Snyder in Germany, 254. It's a nice clay with 25% small piece, small size grog, and it's very nice to throw in. And also, it's actually very good wedged in the back, so I don't actually have to wedge it. I do wedge it a little bit anyway. But once you decide on the clay, you need to decide on what kind of strategy, what way you will throw bigger things. There are many ways you can do that, of course. What I usually do is when I go above 30, 40 centimeters, I usually use sectional throwing. That's probably what I'm going to do today. Let's see how it goes. Sectional throwing is the art of putting together several pieces when they're sort of wet, light, leather hard maybe, but light, wet enough to be able to connect. Another strategy that I haven't been using is to use a combination of throwing the first part and then using coils to add to make it bigger. I haven't used that because I'm not very good with coiling, but maybe one day I will try that. And of course the last solution is that you just basically take a bigger chunk of clay and you throw it in one piece. I think that's very difficult. I can't really get much higher than 40, 45 centimeters in one go. I'm still practicing, maybe one day I will. But so far, I've mostly been doing sectional when I make it bigger. The last consideration is your kiln. My oil drum is 55 centimeters wide, and I like to have my pieces flat and not vertical, because the way I fire, it will be too hot in the top before the fire reaches the bottom, and I'm afraid it will crack that way. So I want them to lay down. And so I have 55 centimeters, 57, I think. But I don't want to make it more than 52, 53. I want a little bit of space in the edges. So that's what I'm aiming for. Of course, there is a shrinkage. This particular clay will shrink about 10%, but it's not 10% in the height. I made that mistake once. So if I make it, let's say, 60 centimeters and expect it to shrink 10 centimeters, that would be 54 centimeters then. It's not going to be. It's going to be more than higher than that. So to reach 52 centimeters, I'm probably not going to make it any bigger than 54. So that's my goal, 50, 54, 55 maybe in width. So let's get on with that. I'm probably not going to talk as much as I usually do, which some of you may find good. Anyway, I always start out by clapping it in place. The more centered you can get it before you start turning the wheel, the easier it will be. So I think this is pretty good. Coning up and down just a little bit helps to kind of wedge it on the wheel, but also it sort of aligns the particles so they're all kind of floating in the same direction, and it sort of helps keeping it very centered. It can be helpful to sometimes use the tip of your fingers instead of your whole hand, because you can apply more force with the tip of your fingers instead of the whole hand. I think that's okay. So now I'm ready to open it up. Sometimes when I'm in doubt how deep the button is, you can use a potter's nail. In this case, it's way too much. I still need to get deeper. I think with bigger chunks of clay, it can be more difficult than if you have a small piece of clay. For a piece like this, being this big, I may turn it and trim the foot. I'm not sure, it depends a little bit of what shape I'm ending up with. But in any case, I don't want a very big or very deep foot. So I will try and leave the button to about, this is still a little bit too much. I want it to be about a centimeter, maybe a little bit more, but not much more than that. Now we're getting closer. At this stage, I'm not looking so much on the outside, but I'm trying to find out what is the base that I want. Why do I want it in the base? In this case, I'm looking for a shape that goes up a little bit like that and then ends up like this. So I'm not going to make it too big in here. A little bit more maybe. And I always make sure to keep the rim compressed and centered. And now what I do is I actually go deeper in the corner. I mean, you could make it 90 degrees, or you could make it, if it was a ball, you would make it a little more shallow. But in this case, I'm actually going in like this. And the reason I do that is because it's usually the clay at the bottom that is difficult to get up. So if you have a tall piece, you end up with too much clay down there. And you want to get that clay up. Of course, you can always trim the outside, but then you kind of waste the clay. Of course, you can reclaim it, but still, I want to get as much clay into the pot as possible. And I found that if you make this indentation in the bottom, it's a little easier because then you can start pulling that up from the inside. So I'll do that in a second. What I'm doing now is just making sure that the base is compressed. The better it's compressed, the less likely is it that you get cracks at the bottom. I'm not actually trying to remove anything down there. I'm just trying to make sure that it's even and compressed. And I think that's good now. And now I'm not actually starting pulling yet. I'm just kind of coning or pushing up. So I grab the indentation from the inside. I'm using that to pull up the clay a little bit. And at this stage, it's important to keep it in this sort of pyramid shape, because you can always expand it in the top, but it's very difficult to get it in. So I'm gonna reduce the base here. In, compress the rim, Now I'm getting ready for the first pull. I'm trying to build this inlay here, so I have something to grab onto with the clay. I need to make sure that it's slippery enough on the inside. I don't want to use too much water, and especially with bigger pieces, because it does take some time. I'm going to throw on this for a few more minutes, and if I use too much water and leave it too much time, it's going to soak into the clay and weaken it. There's still a bit too much clay at the bottom, and I want to get more of that up into the pot. What I personally think is most difficult with throwing a larger pot is to get an even wall size. What I often, maybe not so often anymore, but what I used to often have a problem with is that I could pull a lot of clay from the bottom, and then somewhere around here, in the middle third of it, it became too thin, because the pressure I applied at the bottom, I kept the same pressure, and then when you get to the middle, you don't actually need that much pressure, but keeping the same pressure becomes too thin, and then it becomes wobbly, because it just can't sustain the weight. So you have to loosen up as you get up. And then in the top, of course, loosen even more. Also, another problem is, now I'm probably going to put another section on this, but in case I wasn't, then you often end up with a top that is too thin. And then when you wanna squeeze it in, there's not enough clay to do that. You need quite a lot of clay to squeeze it in, and then you can expand it and make it bigger and thinner. And even though I'm going to expand the size, I do want it to go out a little bit here. I'm keeping it a bit more narrow at the top, because it's very, very easy to make it wider. It is very difficult to make it more narrow. I'm not going to take more away at the bottom, because if this is going to be quite tall, I need some clay down there to hold on to it. I do want to see if I do want to check the thickness of the wall. I think it's actually good at the bottom, but I think just about here we think we can take up a little more. Just take it easy, kind of go with the grow, or with the groove, follow the groove of the clay. There's no reason to rush this. Another problem that I had, still have sometimes, is the positioning of my hands. I used to just put them more or less together and squeeze the clay, and that doesn't actually give you more height. What you need to do is push out with this hand, push in with this hand, or if you do it the opposite way, but most people would do it like that, out here, in here, and then you can get this bubble of clay. Yeah, it's raining outside, so it's quite noisy. I hope it's okay. And then you get this bubble, and you can move up the clay, and that way you actually move the clay and not just compressing it. And another thing is, I mean, don't rush it, unless you're trying to increase your hourly rate, which I'm not, because I'm just doing this for the fun of it. Then take it easy. I mean, the clay doesn't dry out. In fact, the water you apply weakens it. Taking some of that away, you can do it on the way, and you can also do it in the end. But making sure that you keep it moist, slippery, but not completely wet, will help keep the shape and keep the strength of it. Still gonna leave some of that down here at the bottom. I will trim that off in the end, but I want to have enough strength to build on. Another thing is, you probably noticed, I'm trying to support my arm here. If I was doing it like that, it's much more easy to get it on even. So I'm trying to support as much as I can. And when I reach this this height where I can connect my hands, I do that. The sooner you can connect your hands, keep them stable, the better. I think we can get a few more centimeters out of it. It's now a little less centimeter thick, the wall. I think I will make the wall a little thinner and this first section a little higher, but not so much, because I still want to do some trimming, and I want to make sure that the lower part is strong enough to carry the weight of the next part. And now may also be a good time for you to clean up the inside, the button on the inside, because you don't want any slip or water, and especially water, you don't want that to sit in there, because the water is going to soak into the button and it's going to weaken it, and it increases the likelihood of cracks dramatically. So we want to clean it up and just keep it moist but not wet. Also, it looks nice if anybody looks inside at some point. So what I'm going to do now, and again, because I have no rush, I'm not a production potter, and I don't have to make a living out of this, so I can take it easy. What I will do now is I will just use my metal rim rib, and I will just take off the slip on the outside. See, this is just slip. And of course, this will go into my reclaim bucket for later. Just take a little bit more here. This is not actually taking off any clay. It's just it's just slip. And so what that does is that it cleans up, and it makes it more stable, and it makes sure that there's no water on the outside that's soaking in and weakening the pot. And I clean it up on the inside. So what I will do now is I will actually take a short break. I'll wash my hands, adjust the camera so you can see the next levels of it. And it will actually dry up just a little bit, which is fine. It will make it easier for the next stages. Back again, I had a little bit of coffee, and the clay have now just settled a little bit. It was only 15 minutes or something, but it does somehow help make it a little more solid. I don't know if that's the right word, but just a little more stable. When I put water on the inside, I take good care not to have it go too far down, because I'm just gonna work right now. I'm just gonna work a little bit on the top. It's only about 37, 38 centimeters at this point. And as I'm aiming for 52.4, I will need another 20 centimeters, which is not so much. It's only half of this for the second part of it. I will try and pull just a little bit. I think I want to do just a little bit of shaving because, as I mentioned, I will be cutting some of this down here in the base when I'm finished. But I want to keep it now because it's not very thick. It's just maybe 1 centimeter, so it's a little thicker here than it is up here. But I want to keep that for now because it will help. It will help the pot be a little more stable. And I want that. But what I want to do is, I do want to shape it a little bit because eventually it will go out like this and go up and have a top like that. So I can't, because I'm not going to dry this completely before I move to the next top. I will dry it a little bit, but not so much. I will do some of the shaping now. I can still do some shaping after I put the next section on, but it's just easier if I do some of it now. So, I think that's better. Now I just want to clean up the surface a bit and make sure that it's completely even. And this is just slip. It's the first section is almost done. Just gonna make it flat here because it's gonna make it easier for the next pot or the next part, the next section to attach. And I want to make sure that it is as even as possible. Because the more circular this is, the more even it is. The better, of course, the next section that I will put on top will attach. I think that looks good. So the last thing I will do is I will just clean my hands a little bit. And then I will use a heat gun. It's going to make some noise. I'm just going to heat not the top part because I want that to be as soft as possible, so it's easier to connect to the next section. But the lower part I will just heat a little bit to just bring some strength into it. So now I'm ready to do the next section that I will put on top of this. But before I move it, I'm gonna mark my bed, because even though these are factory made beds, they're still maybe not 100% even, meaning that the holes may be a little off center. And so I need to be able to put this bed at exactly the same angle on the wheel. So I already made a mark here. I'm just gonna do it again. And I'm just gonna draw a small mark on my wheel head. So now I know I can put it back in the same position and make sure that it's as centered as it is now. I'm just gonna remove this carefully and put it aside and do the next. Oh yeah, one thing I actually forgot to do, I can still do it, is I wanna measure the size of the rim, because the next section of course have to be exactly that size to fit. I'm ready to do the next section, and for that I'm using a little less clay. This is about 3 kilo, a little less than 3 kilo, because the top section is going to not be as high as the first section. Also, I can throw the top a little thinner, so I can actually stretch it more. And also, because I'm not drying the first part to leather hard, I need to be careful how much I put on top, because if I put it too much, it won't be able to carry the weight and it will break. So that's the reason for that. And I already made my mark here. So this is the size I'm aiming for. The top has to be, because then I'm going to turn it around and put it on top of the first section. And this part, I'm throwing all the way down to the wheel head, because it is just a tube that I'm going to turn around and put on top. And of course, I want a hole in the top of my vase. So this is easier in that way. I'm going to use, of course, more of the clay, because we don't need a base for this. It does make it a little less stable, of course, because there's less clay down there, so you have to be a little more careful. You can pull it off your bed. I will leave a little more clay down there than what I need, so it will be a little thicker down there. We can use that to throw and extend it once we put it on, but I'm just doing that because otherwise it gets too unstable. One of the challenges with the sectional throwing is, of course, to get the exact right size. But you also need to have a thickness that is very accurate or very close to the one you have in the first section. So far, it's just a question of pulling it, of course. The first part of it is just like any other pot. So, see, it's actually just about the right size, so you need to be careful now not to make it any wider, because, as I said a few times now, it's easy to make it wider. It's very difficult to make it more narrow. So we still have plenty of clay here. And of course, for this, you don't need to have a lot of clay up here, because this is actually going to be the top. This is where I'm going to color in the neck. This is just going to connect to the other part. So they actually have to be very precisely the same thickness, or at least that's the best. Also, this part I can actually shape quite a lot after I attach it, because this is going to be completely wet. Or more or less, I'm just going to dry it just a little bit so it's easier to handle, but basically it's going to be quite wet. So I can do lots of shaping on the second section. So I'm not too concerned with the actual shape of this. I do want to remove some of the water down here. That's just because it's less messy when I cut it up. Yeah, now we need to make it wider, which is fine. I think, let me see. No, I don't think, yeah, here. I need to add a bit of water. I will see again. It's actually very close. It needs to be a little bit wider, but that's gonna come more or less automatically when I finish up the shaping. See, so that's going to connect, and I'm already colored it in, so to speak, because this is the white part of the vase. It's, remember, it's going to turn around. You have to think upside down. And so this is going to be the very top. So I'm already making this a little more narrow. That's going to make it easier for me. This is going to connect, so it have to be exactly the same size. The width looks good. The width of the wall and the width of the pot is, well, I think it's perfect. It could be a little more narrow. Let's just check again. Yeah, I think that's good. Pull in just a little bit. Yeah, that's perfect. I'll just make it a flat top. When I put it together, more or less wet by wet, or wet in wet, you don't actually need much scoring, but I'm just going to do just a little bit here, and I will do the same on the other part. It does help a little bit, but really don't need that much. I'm just going to wash my hands, and then I'm going to dry just a little bit, not too much again, because I do want to be able to continue the shaping. So I'm ready to move this. Just be very careful when you do that, because at this point you don't want, of course, to distort it in any way. And now putting this back, remember that I made a mark on the bed, and I have a mark on the wheel head here, so they need to align. Just removing this slip, so like that. So see, it's still perfect centered. So now I will just also score this very lightly. Doesn't need much, like that, and I will give it just a little bit of slip, just a little bit from my pocket here, not so much again. It is already sort of wet, so it doesn't actually need so much, but again, it's just been sitting there for, I don't know, half an hour or something, so just to be sure. So that's it. Now we're ready to put the other part on. And a couple of things here. This can go wrong, terribly wrong. Because if it's not strong enough here, if it's not strong enough here, it can collapse. I actually had that happening with the first piece, the first section, or the second section. You can see how it went here. It's actually moving around a bit. I'll see if I can get my hands down here. Wow, nope. This is a fail. It failed. Yeah, I hope it goes better with this one. So when you turn it, you have to kind of throw it up in the air and turn it, because if you just tip it like that, of course it will bend and warp out of proportion. So you kind of throw it up in the air and turn it like that. So hopefully it sticks to your bed. It usually does. So let's see how it fits. That looks pretty good. Lightly tap it, not too much, because you don't want to apply too much downward pressure. But you want it to connect perfectly. You can smooth it a little bit at this point. It's not so important. As long as it a good fit. And this looks like a very good fit. And now you see we have quite a lot of clay up here, which is fine. I could cut some of it away, but in this case I think I'm gonna use it to pull it taller. But before I do anything, I need to wet this a bit, because otherwise I will distort it when I put my hand in there. And I'm gonna squeeze it just a little bit so I get enough room for my hand to actually get in there. Just be careful at this point, because it is attached down here, but it's not secured. So now I can get my hand in there. I can wet this a little bit, not too much. And now you want to work these seams into each other. I usually start with the outside. There's an aesthetic part of this, of course. You want it to look like it's just one piece, but also it's a question of strength, of course. You want the clay to be as if it was just one. So that was the outside. I'm gonna do a similar thing on the inside, which of course is difficult or impossible to show you. But basically I'm doing the same thing. Sometimes it becomes a little bit thicker. I think it's because it's kind of settles down. Not such a big problem. It's easy enough to deal with. Sometimes you can pull it up. Like this. Sometimes you still end up with a little bit of a lump here, either on the outside or the inside. But in that case, when it's still wet or leather hard, you can trim it off. That's okay. Now I need to wet the top a little more so I can pull this this clay. As you see, at this stage I work on a rather slow speed, what I found is that you have to be a little bit careful, because if it's not wet enough up here, if you pull it too strong, you kind of warp it, you bend it around, and then it becomes uneven. So gotta be careful with this and work it slowly. And again, make sure that you keep the neck narrow. You don't want it to be too wide now. So let's see what the height is now. It's 52, so I'm not gonna go much higher than this. I will do a little bit of shaping here, because it needs to be a little bit wider. Yeah, I think that's better. You can't see the whole vase because I can't move the camera far away enough. But it will be a little bit slimmer in the bottom. As I said, I will trim some of that away. So you have to take that into consideration. So if I want this to be a little bit, have a bit wider feel, I can get that either by expanding it here or by trimming it down here. And in this case, it's going to be sort of a combination. Yeah, I think I'm more or less done with the lower part. So to make sure that it doesn't warp around and stuff, I'm just going to give it a little bit of the heat gun. And especially in this area, because this is where it's weakest now. And also this area here, unfortunately, I made it a little bit too thin. So by drying it up, I can work it a little more and still remain the strength. See, once again, it wants to get out, and I'm not gonna let it, so I'm gonna bring it in. And before I close it up too much, I want to make sure that there's no water left at the bottom. It's just a little bit, it's not so much. Again, I don't want any moist or water down there. I'm just gonna wet the top. I'm just gonna leave the bottom as it is because that's more or less finished now, except for the trimming. And in this stage, I'm very careful not to drip any water inside the pot because it's going to be very difficult, if not impossible, to get it out. It is a little bit uneven at the top, so I think I'm just going to cut that now. I have plenty of height anyway. So, now it's better. What I'm trying to do is I want the top to be a little thinner than what I'm going to trim the bottom or the foot to be, but not too much. And with big pots like this, it's always difficult, I think, but I think I'm getting there. I think we're good now. I will be doing some trimming tomorrow, or when it's leather hard. It needs to be not completely dry, of course, but it needs to be strong enough because I want to thin it out in the bottom so it becomes more elegant. And for that, it needs to be much drier than it is now, of course. So a little hard stage will be perfect. So I think that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed it. Let's see here, we ended up with, 52 centimeters. So that's perfect for what I'm aiming for because I needed to fit into my oil drum, pit fire kiln. So I hope you enjoyed it. I will do more videos about wheel throwing these bigger pieces. So please come back, and if you enjoyed, like, share, subscribe, and you'll be notified about new videos. Thank you.